Hi, how are you all? It's after almost 15 days, I am back again to learn something from you. I am happy to see many smiling faces, and then other day also I had a big discussion with Abhishek. He had some doubts and he got all clarified. Now, I want to learn something for the next chapter. Now, before I proceed, Shevag, see whether there is current or not. Is it there? Oh, when I asked current is there, why you are looking top all this? If you ask the same question, I will just keep quiet. What is the teacher telling? Sir, current means that, okay, tube light, fan. Did I say electricity? No, I only said current. You know, current means a flow. What is that electricity now? Tell me. No, electricity is flow of charge. So, once you know this, right, the moment I ask current, why you, most of us look at top? There is misunderstanding. So, now you must have understood. What is going to be our next chapter? Electricity? No, not electricity. Electricity is in your physics. Oh, we have to talk about electrochemistry now. Clear? So, we have to talk about electrochemistry. So, before I go ahead, I have some doubts. Once you clarify all these doubts, right? And afterwards, I have some doubts, you start explaining to me, I will learn and happily I will go back. So, first thing what I understood from you is, electricity is flow of charges. Now, how I can have this electricity? Sir, there are many ways you don't know, I don't know. Now, you start telling, sir, with water we can generate electricity, with thermal way we can generate electricity, with the help of wind we can generate, then something, nuclear, fine. I want only a small amount of electricity, not that one which you are thinking of with a dam built and then afterwards with that, I don't want that electricity. I want only a small amount at home. What is the way? Now, don't say if I want small amount of electricity, sir, construct one dam, fill with then of course generator, sorry, what is that? The turbine, all this, right? I am not that rich to think of and then have small amount of electricity at home. So, what is the way? Not new. Last year, we have already understood in one chapter, redox reactions. I too forgot. You forgot, I also forgot. Before we go ahead for redox reactions, again, two steps if you go back. In 10th standard, we understood some chemical changes. What are chemical changes, types of chemical changes? Sir, now we are in 12th, 10th standard, who will remember? I don't remember. You only have to recall and make me understand. And can you make me understand what are physical changes and chemical changes? If you make me understand what are physical changes and chemical changes, we will just revise what all that we have studied and then we will go ahead for this chapter which we are on. Now, what are physical changes? Physical changes. When there is no change in the composition, there can be change in the state of the matter. If there is change in the state of the matter, we call it physical change. If there is change in composition, whether it remains in the same state or state changes, I am not worried. If there is change in the composition of the matter which is given to me, then we say it is chemical change. That's what we understood, what is a chemical change. And this chemical change, for example, you have hydrogen and oxygen. After some time, you don't have hydrogen, you don't have oxygen. You have water with you. Change has taken place. Properties have changed. How properties have changed? Very simple. Hydrogen can be burnt. Oxygen supports for burning. So, if I have a mixture of hydrogen and oxygen, there should be a lot of burning taking place. But if they get converted to water, if something is burning, we think of water. If the properties of hydrogen and oxygen are still remaining in water, that means if something is already burning, you are adding hydrogen which is further or which can be further burnt, and oxygen is there which will further support for burning. So, that means if you pour water in a substance which is burning, there should be an increase in the burning. Is it taking place? No. That means when a chemical change has taken place, composition has changed, properties have changed, not new for us. Where do we have learned? Now, what are the different types of chemical changes? Again, if we dig back, we will come to know that combination, decomposition, displacement, double displacement, these are the reactions that we have already come across. Then afterwards we said double displacement, then afterwards we further understood in a different way redox reactions. For that we understood what is reduction, what is oxidation, what is reduction, what is oxidation, forgot, I also forgot. What is reduction? Sir, you told so many things. Addition of hydrogen is reduction, removal of oxygen, reduction. Then, sir, you told something more, we forgot. For that only I told I am here to learn from you, and if you start forgetting, right, for me one more year or two more years afterwards, but you have to keep this in memory for a longer period. Now, what is that further which we discussed? Removal of electron, no, addition of electron, reduction. Then if we add electron, what will happen? Something else we studied. For atoms, we don't assign any charge. For atoms, we say they are neutral. But if we add electron to atom, what will happen? It will gain negative charge. Then afterwards, atom, once it becomes anion, how is that we are representing? If you add one electron, two electrons, we are representing by minus 1, minus 2. So, what is reduction in that way? If I write anything on the symbol of the element, 0, minus 1, plus 1, all this, we call that as oxidation number. That is what we said in redox reactions. Yes or no? If you say no, I have to forget. If you say yes, that means you have learnt, right? So, if that 0 becomes minus 1, minus 2, that means we are adding electrons. Addition of electron is reduction, and if we are adding electrons, that is reduction, and with that what will happen? That number which we call oxidation number. So, what is happening? 0 is becoming minus 1, minus 2, like that. That means there is decrease in oxidation number. So, not just addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen, addition of electron, one more is that decrease in oxidation number, reduction. On the same lines, opposite, if I think of, then that is oxidation. What is oxidation? Addition of oxygen, removal of hydrogen, removal of electron. If you remove electron from an atom, what will happen? We say it becomes cation. How do we represent cation? With a positive charge. O plus 1 plus 2, Mg plus 1 plus 2, sodium plus 1. What that which is happening? Oxidation number is increasing. So, increase in oxidation number means we have removed electron or it is the process of oxidation. So far clear? And then afterwards, we understood that double displacement reactions, right, we don't call them as redox reactions. We gave a name for that. If I remember correctly from what all that we discussed, it is called metathesis reaction. And if it is either combination, decomposition, what is happening in this? And displacement, what is happening? In all these changes we found there is going to be change in oxidation number. C plus O2, CO2, oxygen is added. Oxidation, no, seen in different way. What that which you have done? oxygen bonds electrons. We remove electrons from carbon, C becomes plus 4, carbon undergoes oxidation. Those electrons which are removed, added to oxygen, oxygen becomes 2 minus. So, 4 electrons removed, 2 oxygen atoms present in oxygen molecule takes those 4 electrons, CO2 is formed. In this process, we did not just analyze only as addition of oxygen. Going deep, that means we have done two things. We removed electrons, we added electrons. That means both have taken place. Though first we said it is combination, afterwards we concluded that combination is a redox reaction. Same way, decomposition, when it takes place, one species loses electrons, another species gains it, and then after that also we are going to call it as redox reaction. Displacement, one loses electron, another species gains electron, redox reaction. For example, right, Zn plus H2SO4. In H2SO4, you have got H plus ions. Zn becomes Zn2 plus. What happened to those two electrons? Two H plus ions which are there, they take those two electrons, become a hydrogen molecule, hydrogen gas comes out. We said it is a displacement reaction. But what is that which we arrived at finally? It is a redox reaction. Right? So, whether it is combination, decomposition, displacement, all are redox reactions. Now, how to bring out this redox reaction? Whether it is combination, displacement, how to bring out? There are two ways. Put the two substances together, the one which is losing electron, the one which is accepting electron. Put them together, see what will happen. Reaction gets completed. Within a container, the loss of electron and gain of electron has got completed. Then we say it is direct redox reaction. But if I ask a species, your property is to give electrons, you do only that much, you give electrons. The one which wants electrons, right, I will supply those electrons. That means, I will not allow reduction and oxidation to take place in the same container. I will allow them to take place in separate containers. If I allow them to take place in separate containers, there is advantage. Last year already discussed, allow electrons to come out in the process of oxidation. Make use of those electrons or send those electrons for reduction purpose, which is the other side. So, what that which you are doing? In this process, you are having a flow of electrons. Flow of electrons means electricity. So, if I want to generate electricity at home, I will not think of all those which you said in the beginning. I will take two substances which want to give electrons, which want electrons, and keep them separately. And I allow one to give electrons and allow those electrons to go to other side and get accepted. So, what that which I have done? I have generated electricity. So, if I have generated electricity, if I have generated electricity, we give a name for this construction that we did. Right? What is the name that we gave? Yes? Electrochemical cell. So, what is electrochemical cell? Electrochemical cell is a device wherein a chemical change takes place and electricity is generated. We wanted electricity, we generated electricity. And as I said earlier, you have generated electricity, make use of it. Put in a circuit, a bulb will do and enjoy it. No, we will not just stop with that. What is that which we will do? So far we wanted electricity, we understood how to generate electricity. Now we start asking, if I have electricity, what I should do? So now that means reverse the change. If you reverse the change, that is not electrochemical cell. Right? A reverse is taking place. And we call it as electrolytic cell. all this is. So once we know what is an electrochemical cell, electrolytic cell, so what that which we do is, now we start playing with this. Our job is that only, right, when you do not have something, right, you plan to create, and once you have created something, right, you start playing with that. So we understood how to have electricity. Once you have electricity, now in what all different ways I can use it? Electrolytic cell. So if I want electrochemical cell, I should construct a cell where I should have two separate containers, one oxidation takes place, and other side reduction takes place. Already last year we have understood. Now only thing is, right, you have to recall to me and I should go on writing on the board. Because in the beginning only I said, I am back here again to learn from you. Is it clear? So how to represent a direct redox reaction, indirect redox reaction. So once we just recall that, afterwards it becomes easy for us to go ahead. So if I have a container, right, in that some solution, like for example, if I have copper sulfate, if I have copper sulfate,
so
then of course, right, the moment I look at it, last year we understood some balancing of equations, redox method, all that. So the moment I look at it, that immediately what I should do is U2 plus SO4 2 minus. That is automatic, you should keep in mind. And now, if I dip an iron rod in that, copper sulfate is there, and if I dip iron rod in that, the moment I see iron element, what I should write? 0. It is in the 0 oxidation state. So once I dip it and wait for some time, what will happen? This copper sulfate, the blue color slowly fades out. The blue color slowly fades out. Why it fades out? Copper present in that from Cu2 plus, it is undergoing some change. What change is going to take place? Cu2 plus becomes Cu. If Cu2 plus is to become Cu, what is that which I should do? I should add 2 electrons. Add 2 electrons plus 2 electrons. Cu. Now, who will give these 2 electrons? Color is fading. Why it is fading? Cu2 plus is becomes something else. Where is this Cu going? And what that which we see? On the surface of this, on the surface of this iron rod, you see some brown color substance getting deposited. Why that brown color deposition that has taken place? It is nothing but copper. So this Cu2 plus is accepting electrons and it is settling in that. Who is giving electrons? And with the time, this copper sulfate solution later turns pale green. Pale green, we have a substance. FeSO4 solution is pale green in color. So that means your CuSO4 has become FeSO4. And again, as we did for CuSO4, the moment I write FeSO4, immediately I should write, yes, it is Cu2 plus SO4 2 minus. So that means this Fe has become Fe2 plus. If Fe becomes Fe2 plus, what should happen to Fe? It should give out 2 electrons. So Fe becomes Fe2 plus and 2 electrons are given out. What that which has taken place? I take iron, dip it in copper sulfate, a displacement reaction has taken place. What the displacement reaction that has taken place? Copper got displaced by iron. Your CuSO4 has turned to FeSO4. Iron gave 2 electrons, oxidation. Those 2 electrons got added to Cu2 plus. And made it Cu. Everything is taking place in one container. right? We are not doing anything direct. All this loss of electron, gain of electron taking place in the same container. Then that is direct. You don't do anything. The moment you dip iron in that, they do their business and then of course they become happy. But instead of doing this, you are only helping them. You are only helping Fe2 become Fe2 plus, Co2 plus become Cu. But if you want to make use of this change that has taken place, what I should do? Make iron give electrons. Let it get converted to Fe2 plus. Let the electrons that it has given be there with that. And tell this Cu2 plus, you want electrons? I will give you. Wait. So what that which you have done? At one end, you made a species to give electrons, you are in stock with that. Other end, electrons are wanted. Don't give directly, you send through a circuit. And through a circuit when electrons goes, what that which you have done? We have generated electricity, and that is electrochemical cell. So this way will not help to generate or to construct one electrochemical cell. I have to do different. This will not help. This will only help for the reaction to take place, but I am not in a position to make use of that reaction. If I want to make use of that reaction, as I said, Fe2 lose electrons should take place in one container. Cu2 plus to become Cu, it should wait at the other side in another container. And then you can transfer electrons and then of course you can generate electrochemical cell. How? Again, last year we had understood. And just recall, what is that? I have a container. In this container, I take, for example, copper sulfate. Another container, I will take iron rod. That's what I told, no? I took copper sulfate, dipped iron rod. Now, I told I have to allow them, allow the reactions, allow the changes, loss and gain of electrons to take place separately. Take copper sulfate in one container, take iron rod in this. And iron is losing electrons. It has lost electrons or is it remaining as iron? It is remaining as iron, where it has lost electrons. So now I have to provide a scope for iron to lose electrons. So to provide iron to lose electrons, it should be in some contact of ions. So which ions? Again, if it is in contact with Fe2 plus ions, there is some use. But if it is made to come in contact with some other ions, here only redox reaction will take place. If iron is made to remain in contact with Fe2 plus ions, no problem. So if this loss of electron is to take place instead of Fe2 plus ions, if I take some other salt, here only that direct redox reaction, business gets over. Again, no benefit. Now, okay. Cu2 plus ions present in copper sulfate wants electrons. How will you supply electrons? You can't pour electrons into the liquid, no, you can't pour. You need a conductor. Which conductor? There are many metals, use them as a conductor. Take some metal, it is in copper sulfate. So through this metal you want to supply electrons to Cu2 plus. If you take some metal and dip it in copper sulfate, again here itself redox reaction takes place because that metal and copper sulfate, they get involved. So what I should do, what is the way to go out? As you said, iron dipped in iron sulfate in contact. So if copper 2 plus ions need electrons, through some conductor I have to send electrons. Through which metal? That again should be copper. If I take some other metal, here only that business of redox reaction gets completed and again you have to sit and cry. But if you want to get the benefit of this, electrons lost, electrons to be gained, so dip iron rod in iron sulfate, copper rod in copper sulfate, then connect them. Right? So as I said here, electrons are lost, electrons are to be added, just pass, no conductor. Don't think of any conductor, right? That you should not get involved in the electrolyte with which it is in contact. So then after now connect those two. If you connect those two, iron will lose electrons and copper free to press wants electrons. From that end to that end, electrons flow, and in the path, if you have a bulb, bulb will glow. That means you have made use of this chemical change that has taken place and you have generated electricity. So, making use of chemical change taking place, generate electricity, that is the device that I have, that is the electrochemical cell. And this process, right, we say electrochemistry. Or same way, you have electricity, bring out a redox reaction, that is called electrolytic cell. So, here what is that which we are going to do? We are going to make use of redox reactions, generate electricity, or make use of that electricity and again bring out redox reaction. That is what we are going to study in this chapter, electrochemistry. Clear? And before I proceed further, I just forgot to ask, we understood different types of chemical changes, but for different types of chemical changes, always heating will not help. Always heating will not help. Yes, we know. For example, carbon is there, oxygen is there, water is there. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, both are all three are there in glucose, but we can't produce glucose. So then we say carbon is to be converted to carbon dioxide. Okay, carbon dioxide and water are there. Prepare glucose, no? No, again we'll not succeed. Then we say, okay, I should give it to plant. If I give carbon dioxide and water to plant, plant will prepare glucose. Fine. Give carbon dioxide and water to plant, plant will not prepare. Plant still needs something. Just put carbon dioxide, water to the plant and heat. Generally, when we think of any chemical change, what comes to our mind is heat. Take carbon dioxide, take water, put plant in that and heat. Glucose production will not take place. Then we say something else is required. What is that? We say sunlight. Light is required. So, for that chemical change to take place, we want light. For light, we have already understood there is a different term. What is that? Photo. That means chemical change takes place in the presence of light. Photochemical change. If it takes place with the help of heat, thermochemical change. Same way, I have water. From where? Hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen and oxygen gave me water. Take hydrogen and oxygen, just generate a spark in that. In no time, no hydrogen, no oxygen, everything is water. If they are in proper proportion, otherwise small amount of hydrogen may remain in excess or small amount of oxygen may remain in excess. You have water with the generation of one spark, fine. Now I want my hydrogen and oxygen back. Again heat, that will not help. Give light, it will not help. But how to have it? Electricity will help. Electricity will help to break water into hydrogen and oxygen. For that only we had, but that if I want hydrogen and oxygen from water, right, generate, do this with the help of electricity, electrolysis. Same way, I have sodium chloride. For some purpose, I want sodium. Any method that you think of will not help, electricity will help. So, if you want to get sodium, electricity will help. Electrochemical changes should take place, then you can have what you want. So that's how the electrochemical changes you want, how to bring out, and if you have electricity, how to bring out redox reactions. That's all we are going to study in this chapter. Nothing, right, so big and then nothing much difficult. Only thing is, later we will understand, if I have only one metal, only one salt. Oh, sir, you were telling that I should have two metals displacement. So, later we will learn that one metal, one salt enough for me, I can prepare or I can generate electricity. How? We have to wait. Sorry, I will wait to learn from you. Clear? We will see tomorrow. Bye.